Without a doubt, Playboy has earned its spot in history as one of the symbols of the sexual revolution that shaped the modern view of heterosexuality. By creating cultural conversations about sexuality and its commercialization, but its legacy is filled with contradictions. Because how a brand whose core is portraying women as playmates and decorative objects of a stray male desire can be considered as an ally for female empowerment when its actions fit more as just female exploitation for financial gain? Because even when Playboy consistently aligns itself with articles with progressive ideas like reproductive rights, as when they advocated for abortion rights in 1963, the civil rights movement interviewing Malcolm X and Martin Luther King Jr., the LGBTQIA+ rights when advocating for marriage equality in 1955 and supporting the Equal Rights Amendment, even taking a stand in 2016 against right-wing presidential candidates and showing that sex, healthcare, and decisions that surround it shouldn't be attached to shame and the government shouldn't intervene in its citizens' personal life. At the end of the day, Playboy's content reinforces the idea that women are only as valuable as their sexual attractiveness to men, especially heterosexual, powerful, privileged, and mostly white men. As if supporting these movements only meant more advantage to their sales and appearance of visionary.
A demonstration of this was with Playboy's first issue in 1953 that featured a nude Marilyn Monroe, making the first issue an instant success, selling over 50,000 copies according to the Daily News. But even when Hugh Hefner gave credit to Monroe for the initial success of Playboy, Marilyn never signed an agreement to be in Playboy, which means she never gave her consent to appear in the magazine. Another instance occurred during 1963 when journalist Gloria Steinem went undercover as 24-year-old Marie and worked as a Playboy bunny at a Playboy club in New York City to expose a world of low pay, exploitative working conditions, extremely high heels, and sexual demands behind Playboy stores on her article A Bunny's Tales for Show magazine. According to Gloria, in the Playboy Club, they took 50% of every $30 each woman made in tips, 25% of amounts up to $60, and 5% after that. Also, the salary was nowhere near what they promised, and the only reason bunnies were paid $50 a week was because of New York City's minimum wage laws at the time. They were also responsible for maintaining a Playboy acceptable appearance, like buying their own heels, which had to be at least 3 inches, paying what it might be $21 today every day for the upkeep of their costumes, and $5 a pair for nylons that had to be put into the trash as soon as they had a run. And black female employees were not only bunnies, they were called chocolate bunnies.
Also, bunnies would receive faults for things like messy hair, bad nails, bad makeup, eating on the job, and chewing gum. Adding to all of this, being constantly harassed by clients who would offer their hotel room keys, but no matter what happened, they had to smile and pose to encourage Playboy's clients to buy more drinks. And these moves included the bunny stance, a modest pose with one hip jutted out, and the bunny dip, a back-leaning way of placing drinks on low tables without falling out of their costumes. In 2015, claims were made against Hugh Hefner by his ex-girlfriend Holly Madison on her book Down the Rabbit Hole. Madison wrote about her experience as a Hefner girlfriend and how, while living in the Playboy mansion, she became isolated, going through a deep depression over her years with Hefner, and said he was controlling, verbally abusive, and wouldn't allow her to seek therapy. So she found herself justifying his actions because there were other advantages to being in the Playboy mansion. In response to Madison's book, Hefner said that she had chosen to rewrite history to try to stay in the spotlight. In 2016, Hefner was sued by model Chloe Goines, who claimed that Hefner conspired to allow Bill Cosby to drug and assault her at the Playboy Mansion in 2008. Hefner, of course, denied the claims, as if anybody would expect anything else with the constant parties being held at the Playboy Mansion. We can imagine how unsafe the environment must have been, but how privileged you were to be invited. And even when for some of the women who worked with or for Playboy over the years, Hugh Hefner was an ally, like when he decided to place his daughter, Christy Hefner, to succeed him as a CEO of Playboy. For other women like Madison and Gloria, Playboy symbolizes something darker.
So, Playboy needs to be understood within their historical context as a product for the middle class men who felt pressured and limited by the traditional domestic life after World War II and the Great Depression, who felt it was their duty to repopulate the world and embrace the baby boom. But Playboy's vision helped to pave the way for modern ideas about sex positivity. However, we have to remember that Playboy's sexual revolution fails to recognize that sexuality's spectrum goes beyond what it works for the sexual fulfillment of a straight man in Western civilization. And a world that accepts and makes visible sexual desire can only be complete when it allows women of all sizes and LGBTQIA+ individuals to be openly sexual, not to feel the fantasies of the post-war men, but rather discover the many layers of sexuality. After all, today's Playboy magazine now displays photoshoots without nudity. Nevertheless, it continues to leave playmates as the role they once were, which is to have the privilege of belonging to a visionary platform that does not encourage female empowerment, but instead sets a restrictive, non-inclusive role. Finally, for some, Hefner is the great sexual liberator, but to others, he's setting in motion a sexual revolution that objectifies women. And in our opinion, even when Playboy has promoted progressive ideals, its actions have shown that they are sided more with the dark side of the straight, powerful, and Western man's ideal.
It's just the radical idea that women are full human beings.
Yeah, very radical.